Avatar The Last Airbender was able to explain difficult and sensitive topics in a way that children could understand them. Love, loss, guilt, duty, and the inherent gray nature of morality. It is so important to me that I have it tattooed on me as a reminder whenever I feel discouraged. A good story can give perspectives where nothing else would be able to. With all the big studios wanting to abuse other people's stories for profit, I felt the need to comment and show to the best of my ability how they fail time and time again. To illustrate this, I'm gonna make a scene comparison of Aang's escape in episode 2 and its counterpart in episode 1 in the live-action show, as they more or less try to do something similar. Get the gang together and set up the threat of Zuko. This video is directly inspired by Jedi Brooks' scene comparison. Let's get some things out of the way. The show is an incoherent mess that realigns elements of the story with no regards for why they are there in the first place. It breaks canon just to look cool. So here would like a word with you, kid. And the acting is definitely not great. Thing is, I don't even mind it much. No amount of acting could save that dialogue, but at least the costumes, effects, and the set's cool. I weirdly like Aang and Sokka, and the others are substantially less offensive than the ones in the movie, but then again, nothing's worse than that. To quickly address this idiocy, Sokka's sexism was discussed during the live-action show's development and was deliberately cut away, as it had no place in the new remake. As if a few jokes make you an unredeemingly bad person in today's day and age. It's called a character trait, guys. A really important one for the show-off who needs to learn what it means to be a real leader. That is what made the Kyoshi's Island episode so memorable and sweet.
I treated you like a girl when I should have treated you like a warrior.
I am a warrior. But I'm a girl, too.
Compare it to the live-action one that chokes me out of nowhere and makes me want to awkwardly waddle away while contemplating my life choices. It wasn't the writer's way of hating on women. You couldn't have picked a worse show to push that hypocritical-ass agenda. The cartoon has some of the single best female characters of all time. Complex, fleshed-out people with wants and needs, while the Netflix show only boasts wannabe badass warriors who don't need nobody. And I said I like the actors, except maybe the grandma. She just might be the single worst character in television history. Okay, let's get to it then, starting with the original. The exiled prince is lured by the beaming light on the horizon. At this point, we've seen bending in action only a very few times. Aang sees that the villagers will get hurt as he's deflecting the attacks and surrenders to captivity. In that fight, it is revealed to Katara and Sokka that the reason the Fire Nation is here is that Aang is the Avatar.
You're the Airbender? You're the Avatar?
Aang?
No way.
In the show, the Netflix show, we get Grandma Exposition tell us about it.
But when the world needed him most, he vanished.
As well as this abysmal prologue. I mean, abysmal. Two lines show us really nicely where these characters are at.
Take care of Appa for me until I get back.
Head a course to the Fire Nation. I'm going home.
Okay, we're on the ship now. On Zuko's orders, Aang gets escorted to prison.
This staff will make an excellent gift for my father. I suppose you wouldn't know a father's, being raised by monks.
Take the Avatar to the prison hold, and take this to my quarters.
Hey, you mind taking this to his quarters for me?
As Aang gets escorted, he takes his chance and sneezes his way out of custody and then starts booking it. He needs the staff to escape.
The Avatar has escaped!
You haven't seen my staff around, have you? Thanks anyway!
He evades the guards, dodging and weaving, using his mobility, frantically searching the rooms.
Sorry.
He finds it, and with a child's naivete, runs into the trap.
My staff!
Looks like I underestimated you.
Zuko goes for the attack, barraging Aang with fire. Aang evades, not even trying to land a single blow. I wouldn't want to go too much into detail in every single sequence. But just look how expertly this scene sets up so many small things that even in the chaos of such a fight, you are never confused or lose orientation. The banner, the mattress, the staff, the great shot of the whole ship to show where we currently are. And no matter how often I watch that scene, this always hurts.
Ouch!
Zuko manages to catch up, leaping recklessly, clutching onto his foot and bringing Aang to the ground, now ready to finally take him down. This time, Appa and the others show up. Aang sees his way to get out of there, but Zuko won't let his opportunity slip. With a flurry of attacks, Aang gets overwhelmed and falls into the water. And now we get to see a first glance at the immense power of the Avatar. He wrecks the crew with incredible waterbending, collapses, and his friends come in to help.
Now that was some waterbending.
As they escape, Sokka gets some payback for earlier. Katara uses some quick thinking to freeze the guards.
Katara!
Iroh helps his nephew up and on his orders assists in shooting a big-ass fireball. Aang deflects it and buries their enemies in snow, giving them time to escape. All the while this was happening, we had scenes that allow us to follow the other characters. Aang didn't want to fight, just to get away, and everything he did was to get out of there ASAP. Only when Aang was overwhelmed, the Avatar state kicked in. Okay, now what is happening in the Netflix show? Sokka duels Zuko in a pretty cool choreographed fight, but I can't help but think that the only reason Sokka doesn't wear face paint here is because they were afraid that somebody with a single brain cell would complain about it on Twitter.
No way.
Anyways. We start off with Aang protecting the villagers by head-on fighting the others, even clashing Zuko straight on.
Can't be.
The villagers chime in, and just as Zuko ordered to burn them, Aang surrenders.
I'll go with you, just leave him alone. I'm the one you're looking for.
Get him.
Wait! It's okay, Katara. No one has ever fought for me before.
Okay, we're in the ship, and Aang instantly has a heart-to-heart with Iroh, and it is really forced, and it is really bad. Something about why people start war just because Iroh is Iroh and he spouts philosophy mumbo-jumbo all over the place.
There are many who never imagined this day would ever come, myself included. Some people say it is within our nature to expand and consume, like fire itself. Others believe that true stability in this world can only happen under our rule. So the drive to conquer is a drive for peace and unity.
Anyways, after a way too long conversation, Iroh leaves and Aang yeets the keys with his air magic. When we see him next, he's out and in the halls. And this is exactly what I mean. Do you want it to be taken seriously or not? Want me to feel with the characters and all the misery you put them in? Then make the story make sense. Why would there not be guards en masse to see that the most important person in the world doesn't escape your clutches? How can you say it is more realistic than the original if it doesn't even think the most obvious things through? Trying to avoid guards, he just so happens to stumble into Zuko's room because remember, he doesn't need the staff. We can see a mattress, but don't get your hopes up. Just like you'd imagine a bedroom on a ship with all dudes would be in such a gritty and realistic show, no fun allowed. Good thing his staff is there, as well as a book that will come in handy for when the writers completely lose the plot.
The avatars.
Do you see how there's no urgency? There was never an alarm or anybody got notified, so when Aang comes out here, he could just fly away. Dude, what is he doing? He could just go away now. But instead, we get a long ass scene until, for some reason, Zuko shows up because his spidey sense tingled and he's now notified that the Avatar has left.
Stop him!
He has to use his glider now and Zuko orders to open fire without shooting himself. After Zuko stops his men from shooting and fires himself, Aang gets hit, spirals down and gets caught mid-air by Appa, the classic. Zuko shoots another fireball at them, and Katara, who could not even hold a ball of water 5 minutes ago, is now mega powerful and bends enough water hundreds of meters into the air to evaporate that fireball. Oh my god, she is so cool. Yeah, that was it. So, the original introduced and further showed us the characters and also explained the stakes and story while showing us how and why they fight in the first place. One thing led to the logical next step and then the next and so on and so forth. It gave us some great interactions to get to know the characters better, as well as some witty payoffs and moments of comedy. The live action dumped Iroh's philosophy in us, completely disregarding that these two have never met. Iroh has no idea who Aang is. Being the Avatar is no guarantee for being all zen, bro. Certainly not with how Kyoshi is known in this universe. There's no sense of what makes Avatar so great. It isn't just some kids show. It depicts very real principles in a way that kids can understand it. The live action is just riding the coattails and botching what made the original so good. Yeah, shocker, I know. If you would want to make something in the Avatar universe, you 100% could. It's the infuriating thing here. Here, some pitches that would enable to act in the loved universe but tell something completely different. How about Kyoshi's growing up? You already have a hard-on for her in the show anyway, so why not commit fully? How about a story with June? How about something completely different? Go off book so you have like complete creative freedom. Why not a young Earthbender who has to flee from the initial attack of the Fire Nation? That would be a way to get in that genocide that you want. There is no reason to remake Avatar. If you want to experience the story, watch the original. Something like that remake should never exist.
My name is Aang.
And I'm sure we can think of infinitely more pitches. If you feel inspired, please write them in the comments, be as exact or as loose as you want. I would love to know. I hope I could show why Albert Kim didn't make something that was just different and more modern. It is just worse. Even with depicting people burning alive and all other sorts of adult things, the cartoon is more clever, mature, and profound than this mess. Flameo, everybody. Flameo.